In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the third week of this our program. And I believe as you are watching me today, you are watching me for good in the name of Jesus. I believe that you are going to have a successful day as God liveth and the Spirit live in the name of Jesus. Thank you, dear I am that I am. Let's begin to worship the King of Kings. Let's begin to appreciate Him. And to power more at your name.
He that kept us overnight. He protected the land of Goshen. He that covered us. He that does not allow the evil of the night to overcome us. He that covers us with his wings. Even up to this moment.
Begin to worship him.
Exalt his holy name. Why have you not appreciated him?
Lord, I thank
you for your protection over my life. I thank you for your protection over my family. I thank you for the power you used to
give
me from yesterday even to this moment. I thank you because you don't allow me to die overnight. You don't allow the evolution of the enemy to come. You don't allow the power of the enemy to overcome me. I thank you for your mercy over my life. I thank you for your grace that used to cover me. Why not give thanks to you? Give thanks to you. Why not exhaust his holy
name?
All that is great in power might. He that can do all things. He that has power over the
heavens,
the merciful of Israel, exalt him, exalt him. Give thanks to
you.
Give thanks to you.
Only touch me, Yeshu. Only duro me, Yeshu. Many your bad duro in the anti my sorrow. Many your bad duro in the anti my shiregu. Only duro me, Yeshu. Jupelo went to duro for.
Give thanks to your guarantor.
Give
thanks to you that keep you all over the night.
Give
thanks to you that covered you all over the night.
He
alone has the
protection.
He alone has the strength.
Your
doctor cannot stand
you overnight.
Your mom cannot stand before
you overnight.
There's no mighty
one
that can stand before you
overnight.
He's the only guarantor that
you have.
He that keep us as
the
one of these
this army
said I slept and I woke up,
but
the Lord backed me up. The mercy of the Lord is one that I never used to wake up this morning. The mercy of the Lord is one that gives us the grace to be hearing me this
hour.
Give thanks to the merciful one of Israel. Give thanks to you that keep you. Give thanks to you that keep you. Give thanks to you that keep you. Give thanks to you that covered you. Even to this moment, exalt his holy name. Exalt his holy name.
Ile ayo mo gbega oba elerun ni mo gbega mo gbega mo gbega mo gbega mo gbega o oba onile ayo mo gbega oba elerun ni mo gbega emi o ba le dupe aje pe mi o more opo egbe mi ti ku opo egbe mi ti lo opo lo wa le won opo lo se fai barakiri emi o ba le dupe a je pe mi o more opopolopo lo sun bi emi ati re ti sun lale ano
sugbo
se ni laaru pe won o le ji se
mo lojo o ni so
isi ti emi ati re fin gbega ni owuro yi
the reason why you
oni bi ali iwole alaye
is that we are able to see
oni bi asun layo aje layo
we are able to sleep and wake up
layo mo ji layo mo fogo fun luwa mo ji layo baba mo dupe o dupe ni owo re dupe lowo en to pa mo
so go
foru ko mi mo re
o ya
gbe oruko mi mo re
ya
so fun wi po seun 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 alaye je ka yin oluwa o fun re re ati se iyanu re emi alaye
Baba, shalom for me. Baba, daddy, go for
For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Now, because of our time, we are going into the word of God. This is the third week of this program. I've been hearing some good news. I've been hearing some appreciation from our people. So if you are joining us for the first time, watch very well. And make sure you are in spirit. And share the program as much as possible with all your friends. And as you are doing so, I pray that Heavenly Father will bless you. So your cry will not go in vain. In the name of Jesus. My topic for this morning, I tag it the power of the tongue. The power of the tongue. Power of the tongue. I pick my text from the book of Proverbs chapter 18. I read verse 21. I will read it in Yoruba here. Listen very well.
Death and life comes from the power of the tongue.
Àwọn ẹni tí ó bá sì ń lò ó,
those that use it,
yóò jẹ ire rẹ.
You
can see what we read here, that life and death is in the power of tongue. And people that use it, we gain it. So this passage makes us realize that our destiny relates with our tongue. Our destiny has to do with our tongue. How far you will go in life?
Yo se jina to ti wa lo ninu aye yi.
Determine your tongue.
Yo pe awon re ni o pe.
How successful your day will be?
Bi ojo re o se saseyori
to. Maybe you will make it under the power of the day.
Boya wa ri se lagbe agbara ojo.
Maybe you will gain under the power of the day.
Boya wa ri re ire gba labe agbara ojo.
Or you will lose under the power of the day.
Abi wa sonu labe agbara ojo.
Your tongue determine.
Awon re ni o pe ni re.
So according to where we read now, this passage makes us realize that your tongue determines your destiny. Your tongue determines your life. Your tongue determines your success. Even though your tongue determines your breakthrough, so there is a life in your tongue. If you want life in your business, your tongue determines. If you want life in your system, your tongue determines. You're going out and coming in. If you want life in it, your tongue determines. Many people use their wits. They use it in vain without being pointed to anything. Because they don't understand the principle of tongue. They don't realize the power in their tongue. Some people use their days. They will go out from morning to night, but they will not be able to point to to any good thing. Because they don't understand the power of tongue. Your tongue determine your success. Your tongue determine your breakthrough. Whatever that brings life, whatever that brings success, whatever that brings testimony, whatever that brings is power, your tongue determines. What you say with your tongue determine what will happen to your life. So that is the reason why this passage makes it clear that is a life in your tongue. That life and death lie in your tongue. If you want to go out in the morning and you want to have life, you want to have a successful day in your business, you want to feel life in everything you do, in the power of the day, you want to feel life. What am I trying to say? Your tongue
determined.
In a such way, your tongue is a seed. Your tongue is a seed. Whatever you use your tongue to sow into the day, determine what you will reap under the powers of the day. If you sow calamity, you will definitely reap it. If you sow doubt, you will definitely reap it. But if you sow confidence, under the power of the day, you will definitely repeat. So, tongue is a seed. That is the only seed you can sow to have a successful day. The Bible says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so he be. Suppose you run into a
That's what will come out of your mouth.
Whatever you say, how you're thinking determines. You think it before you say it. If you think that in the power of the day, you will succeed. You will definitely succeed. If you think within you that in the power of the day, you will lose. You will definitely lose. So that is the reason why whatever you want to do, whatever you want to become, how far you will go in life, lies on your tongue.
Oh, what nipa on
it? Lies
on
your tongue. How are you using your tongue? How are you using your tongue? Most of the time, I want you to understand something this morning. When you woke up early in the morning, what you confess to your life, what you confess to your destiny, determine what will happen to you. Amongst our image, amongst the organ of our system, we see tongue as one of the small organ. But to your own surprise, small organ is the one that determines your destiny in life. It's the one that determines your destiny under the power of the day. It's the one that determines your destiny under the power of the month. So what you say determines what will happen to you. Some people will keep silence. Yeah, they're supposed to talk. Some people will make a wrong conversation upon their life. You will see some people wake up in the morning and be shouting,
yeah,
Bobe,
they will be saying, oh, I'm done.
What you confess.
Ohun ti o be nu re so.
Determine.
Ohun ni o pinu.
What we happen.
Ohun ti o sele si o.
Let's go to the word of God.
Eya lo sinu oro Olorun.
Let's check the word of God.
Eya wo oro Olorun.
The book of Numbers.
Iwe Numeri.
Numbers chapter 13.
Iwe Numeri ori keta.
How many people?
Eya melo.
Went to the Canaan land.
Lo lo si le Canaan.
I want you to take notice of something great.
Mo be ke to ke
sakiso. How many people went to this land?
Eya melo lo lo sinu ile yi.
The tongue of most of them cut them off.
Oh, okay, okay.
They went to the land. They saw the
goodness
of the land. They saw the fruit of the land.
Even
though they are able to bring the fruit of the land, but their tongue witness against them. Their tongue command against them. Their tongue tells them that they cannot make it. Numbers chapter 13. I read from verse 25.
And they went back from the land. For 40 days. And they went and came
to Aaron and to Aaron
and
to all
the congregation of
the children in Pharaoh, witness against them.
But
what you confess, with your tongue.
Determine
what will happen to you under the powers of the day. If you woke up in the morning and you say you will not make it, then you cannot make it. But if you woke up in the morning and you said I woke up today, thank you, Jesus, because I will make it. Thank you, Jesus, because you will have your way in my life. Thank you, Jesus. Because today will profit me. Definitely. That day will profit you. When you wake up in the morning, you begin to confess yourself. You begin to confess it to your life. Ah, today is difficult. Ah, you will teach you when you The first thing you utter, early in the morning, immediately you wake up, the first thing you utter to your life is like a magnet. It's like a magnet. So it has to do with your destiny. So as you are going into the gallery of that day, the first statement you make early in the morning, that statement will be following you. You are the one that said it. You said you cannot make it today. Why? The Bible said, life and death lies in your tongue. So what you confess early in the morning that you woke up, determine what will happen in your life throughout that day. Every kind of God that will succeed, every kind of God that really believe in God that they are serving, must prophesy a good thing
into their
life.
Why?
Your tongue is the power of your destiny. Your tongue is the power of your success. So whatever you say in the morning, determine what will happen under the power of today. I command, I pray, and I prophesy every power, every spirit that always bring wrong words, wrong commands, wrong conversation into your tongue every morning, wrong thinking, evil thinking, every power that brings it into your life. This morning, I destroy their work. I destroy their work. Verse 39. Now look at this man. Verse 30. Kele pusi pa awon eniyan na lenu mo niwaju Mose. O si wi pe a je ke po ke lo lekan. Classic back. Nitori pe awa le se. Can you imagine this? A man like you was the one talking here. A man like you was the one that silenced these people that comes with wrong conversation, that comes with wrong testimony, that young people shut up. I know who I'm serving. I have power in my tongue. I will go there. We will go there. Any of you that believe, we go with us. And we will gain the land. What I'm trying to say is that you confess under the power of today, determine what will happen. Most of us that we call ourselves woke up in the morning.
Ajila love
to make God first.
Lati gbe Olorun sakoko
in our life.
Ninu aye wa.
We find it difficult.
O man nira.
Some people will sleep in their bed like this.
Asun ni oreji mu ti
won ba. Yeri lo yi lo.
Wa ma gbo ti awon
Muslim. Yeri lo yi lo.
Wa ma gbo ti won ma
kiru. Those people will wake up.
Awon eyan ti
rush out giri giri.
Wa sare jade.
Go into their body today to their way of worshiping God.
Lati lo si ona ba o se ma
so Olorun.
Lati lo gba
jura. Commit their way.
Lati fi odun won.
The hands of the Lord. But some people will sleep on their beds. As you are hearing their noise. From different places,
you
just see them sleeping on their beds. And be a magic kriba. Instead of them to woke up and command the
day,
instead of them to wake up and use their tongue, authority that God gave their tongue under the power of the day, they'll just be
sleeping.
That is the reason why many people go out every day without being pointing to any good
thing.
Why? Their tongue witness against them.
So,
what you say with your tongue, if you are a man like a Caleb, you will wake up in the morning and open your mouth. I woke up today. You day, I command you. Go and bring my testimony. You day, I command you. Go and bring my sources. You will command the day. And today have no option. Proverbs chapter 12, verse 26. Amen.
Amen.
Proverbs 12.
We are wearing kejila.
26.
Ori kejila.
Olu do to ala dugo re lo. Si ona. Suba awe eniyan
buru.
Mu won sinna.
Seduce them.
Mu won sinna.
Mislead them.
Mu won sinna. The calibers of people.
Ipele awon eyan.
That you are moving with.
Ele ti o nba rin.
You are relating
with. Ele ti o nba se.
Determine. What we are.
So
when you are living with people,
a kind
of people that have wrong motive,
living
your life under wrong motive.
That's
the reason why some people woke up in the morning and they will not have any good thoughts. I have seen some people that woke up in the morning. I went out for morning cry one day, and as I was going, I got a spot. Around 5:30 like this, and I saw people, like 15 people, they are drinking alcohol early in the morning, a time to command the day. I want to alert you.
They want to their neighbors.
He say, let him run
along. He's not to help them.
He say, let him pass it for
not to command the day.
Let him move him, move him.
Or to take someone.
Let the witness of Caleb,
that's
Caleb witness,
that
let's go there. Why? We can make it. We now go to the verse 14. Chapter 14. Around verse
28.
Talk to Moses.
What are
they displeasing?
Whatever you say, my ears.
Listen to that word. So that simply means God has given your tongue and authority to bless your life or to curse your life. One of the two we have. Either you use your tongue to bless your life or you use your life or your tongue to curse your life. So what must happen? Out of the two. So God was the one speaking here.
Go
attend them. If you say it in my ear, that you will make it. Under the power of the day, you will make it. If you say it in my ear, under the power of the day, that you will not make it. Your tongue is the power of your testimony. Of your destiny. So what you say in my ear will be what I will do. What you confess in my ear will be what I will do. Matthew 7:7.
So ask.
Lies in the power
of God.
So what you have under the power of today determine what you will receive. Ask, and it shall be given unto you. So what are you going to ask today? Are you going to ask for breakthrough? Are you going to ask for success? Are you going to have ask for sound health? Are you going to ask for blessings? Are you going to ask for new customers? Are you going to ask for new connection? Are you going to ask for new contract? Or you are just going out. So what to ask under the power of the day determine what will happen to you. So you have to change your thinking. Once you change your thinking, then you change your life. Anyone that did not know the principle of changing of thinking can never experience a life change. So changing of thinking. So wake up in the morning. Let your thinking be positive. Say a good word to your life. Say a positive word into your life. Whatever you say, the power of the day will follow you. As you are going. As you are going. As you are going. Anywhere you go, if you move to the light, to the left, you will see the power of your body. If you move to the left, you will see the power of your tongue. So that is the power of the tongue. Before we round up today, John in the book of Mouth, there is a powerful word there that I want us to check together. Mark 11. I will read from verse 20. From verse 23. From verse 23. Lord, turn the boy for you. And the Kenny Toba will for you. Look at it. Look at it. Under the power of
God,
there are a lot of money.
What
God said, any Kenny,
whosoever,
Toba will for you.
That says to the mountain,
we pay. Any Kenny,
whosoever, he does not say some set of
pastor.
He does not say the pastor. He does not say the prophet. He does not say the evangelist.
Any Kenny,
whosoever,
any Kenny,
whosoever,
as you are hearing me, any Kenny,
whosoever,
Toba will for you.
That says to the mountain,
CD, you see, busing up,
and the pastor is
in the sea. See a
man,
you are correct. But your back, but where?
Oh,
so we
will
share.
You see, shall be whatever
you say. What you say to
God, if
you believe that it will happen in your life,
you know,
it will definitely happen.
It
will definitely. It is your choice now.
Choose
whatever that you want to happen to you under the power of God. It is your choice. It is your choice. It is your choice. If you choose to succeed under the power of God, you will succeed. If you choose to succeed, God have command.
Yes,
lay down the protocol that
whatever
you say will be what will happen to you. But what are the three things that you need to help your tongue? You must have a strong belief in who you are serving. You can see it where we are. That you must
believe. That if you should believe,
I will
serve ourselves to this mountain. Be a move.
See,
be moved.
See, opposite back.
And believe.
Your belief Determine your receipt. Your deep belief. Determine your receipt. So if you have faith in the Lord, whatever you say, under the power of the Spirit, heaven will stamp it. Heaven will stamp it. And it will happen as you said it. The second thing, you must work on your thinking. Your positive thinking will help your positive day. If you don't have positive thinking, under the power of the day, you woke up in the morning and you occupy your house with evil thoughts. Forget about success. Under the power of God. But if you have positive thinking, you woke up in the morning and your thought was telling you that today you will succeed. My brother, my sister, you will succeed. You woke up in the morning and something was telling you that today is going to be a blessed day. Today is going to be a successful day. Today I will make it. Without any doubt, I am telling you, you will succeed. You will succeed. So your thinking determine what you will achieve. Under the power of the day, what you think determine what you will receive. What you think determine what you will grab under the power of the day. The third thing that you need to hold as you are going under the power of the day, you must hold your confidence. You must have that confidence that I am going to the power under the power of today. If every other people was defeated, I will not be defeated. If every other people failed under the power of the day, I will not fail. As a man thinks, so he is. So what you think, under the power of God, determine what will happen to you. Determine what will happen to you. Determine what will happen to you. So your belief, your thinking, and your confidence will not generate good things. So you will not discover, you go out, everything will go well. You go out, everything went well. Anywhere you go, you just see people blessing you. Why? You have laid a solid foundation for the day to favor you. And I pray for someone today that you will favor you. Anywhere you go, under the power of the day. Anywhere you go, under the power of the day. Heavenly Father will succeed you. Heavenly Father will make it for you. Under the power of the day, you will make it in Jesus' name. Under the power of the day, you will succeed in Jesus' name. Under the power of today, anywhere you go, therefore will speak for you. Therefore will be your portion. Therefore will be your portion. You will make it. 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 In the name of Jesus, today will be a wonderful day. Will be a notable day in your life. In the name of Jesus. You start today with the power of God. I pray for you. Throughout of this week, you will not lack of anything. You will not lack of success. Your tongue will lead you to the land of your success. Your tongue will lead you to the land of your blessing. So as I'm talking now, I want you to begin to command today. I speak as a child of God under the power of God. Today, hear the word of God. Hear the word of God. I used my tongue as a child of God to prophesy under the power of today. Anywhere I go today, I must receive favor. I prophesy as a somebody that have authority in his tongue. Today, hear the word of the Lord. Today, hear the word of the Lord. Today,
you are just the God of Lord.
Go and prophesy. I will make it. In today, I will not fail. In my business, I will not fail. In my going out, I will not fail. In my coming in, I will not fail. But I will succeed. In the name of Jesus, I will succeed. In the name of Jesus, begin to prophesy in your life. You will gain it. If you make use of it, you will gain it. I want you to open your mouth to us and pray unto the Lord. Evil of evil thoughts that always divide my day, I command you out of my life. Evil thoughts that always divide my day, that always mislead my day, I command you in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, arrow of evil thoughts that always divide my day, that always divide my focus, I cast you out. In the name of Jesus, 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 every arrow of evil thoughts that always divides my day, that always divides my focus, that always says evil things into my life, I cast you out. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
I want you to pray unto the Lord. I use my tongue today as a child of authority. I pray into the power of today. You today, hear the word of God. Everywhere my goodness hides you. In the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
By the authority in my tongue, I clear my way today. I will not see any injustice. I will not see any injustice. As I am going, in the power of God, I will make it in Jesus' name. I will succeed in Jesus' name. My business will profit me. My going out will profit me. My coming in will profit me. How we not lack of any good thing. I will not lack of blessing. Today will profit me. Begin to talk to God. Lose the power of today. Hear the word today. Hear the word of the Lord. Go and profit me. Go and profit me. You must profit me. You must profit me. I will succeed under the power of today. As God liveth and his spirit live, I will succeed today. In the name of Jesus. Talk to God. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I will succeed under the power of today. As I am going out today, I will succeed in the name of Jesus. Thank you, the I am that I am. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Now I want you to begin to give this.
Lord, I thank you.
Because today is my day.
Because
I will make it today. Talk to God. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Our Father, our God, we thank you. We say thank you for this wonderful morning. We say thank you over the life of your children. We say thank you because you will bless their day. We say thank you because you will make a way for them. Even where there is no way, we say thank you because you will make a way for them. Daddy, glory be to your name. I pray for you as you are going out today. Go and succeed in the name of Jesus. I pray for you as you are going today. Go and make it in the name of Jesus. Go and make it. I pray for you today. By the time you will come back, under the power of today, you will have many reasons to give this to God. Your testimony is sure. Your breakthrough is sure. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Your testimony is sure. In the mighty name of Jesus. Go and have your testimony. By 9 p.m.
Ni agbo mesan.
Thank you, everybody. God bless you.